Hello and welcome to our YouTube channel. I hope you have already subscribed the channel. I am Chanchala Tiwari, your companion in this journey. And thank you very much for liking my previous video. So in the previous video, we have discussed about writing skills. You might be thinking how to start writing. There must be some basic things which you need to understand. So in this video, I have brought some of the ideas through which you can really develop your basic competency for writing skills. So let's see what is there. Now there is a question that how can we start writing? What is the procedure? Kaise likhe? Kya likhe? This is a very big question. It's not that easy. But, you know, there are several ways in which writing can be started, provided core skills and core competency to write. Now, what are these core skills or core competencies or the ingredients which you really need to start writing? So, these are vocabulary. Vocabulary is a set of words which I have told you in my previous video. So, when you have different words for different situations, for different contexts, you can always start writing. That means you must have a good set of vocabulary for writing. This is a key ingredient for your writing skills. Second is grammatical skills. Now, grammatical skills is always an inbuilt system of the language. You know, what is grammar? It's a science, which I have told you already in my previous video, that grammar is the science through which we can organize the sentences, through which we can make the sentences. In order to make correct sentences, correct reading, correct writing, you need grammatical skills. So it is the basic foundation. So it is very important that you must have the basic core competency of grammar. Like you must know what is verb, what is pronoun, what is adjective, what is adverb. These are a few of the things which we'll generally understand and acquire with the reading and writing procedures. Ye alag se nahi seekhna hota, but aapko pata hona chahiye ki ye isme kya hai. The next thing is, which is very important, is the sentences. Ultimately, this is the first thing which you need to make. If you have the ability to construct sentences, you can really write anything. That is why it's always been told that always start with a simple sentence. Agar aap ek sentence bana paate hain, then you can definitely be able to develop a paragraph. That sentence can be converted into paragraphs and that into an essay and that into even a book. Now, if you are able to make a sentence, you must have the ability to organize the sentences. How you will organize those sentences into a sequenced and flow. That sentences which you have written, jo aapne likha hai, wo ek flow mein hona chahiye. Agar if someone is asking you about your introduction, the first thing will be your name. That can't be your last thing to tell. Okay? So that is the flow of a sentence, of a paragraph, where you have to follow the sequence or that flow need to be maintained in a sentence. And you must have the ability to use precise, adequate and appropriate words so that whatever you are writing can be very clear to your readers. If you are not using the precise words or adequate words or appropriate words, your reader will be confused. उन्हें समझ ही नहीं आएगा कि आप बोलना क्या चाहते हो अपने लिखने के हिसाब से. आप जो लिख रहे हो उसके थ्रू व्हाट यू वांट टू प्रेजेंट, व्हाट इज योर बेसिक आइडिया बिहाइंड इट. सो इन ऑर्डर टू बी श्योर दैट यू आर राइटिंग द सेम थिंग विच यू वांट टू राइट, योर राइटिंग इज कन्वेइंग द सेम मैसेज, प्रिसाइजनेस, एडिक्वेटनेस एंड अप्रोप्रिएटनेस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि आप ये सारे चीजों को यूज करें so that you can be able to write. If you have good vocabulary, if you have the grammatical skills, if you have the ability to construct sentences, organize them, if you have the good precise words, adequate words for different situations, you can always start writing. And let's see how we can start writing. Now, how to acquire these skills to start writing? Yes, skills hain jinko you have to acquire so that you can write, but kaise, how you can acquire. So in this video today, I will be telling you about how you can really acquire the skills of vocabulary or grammatical, or how can you achieve them. So let's see. But first of all, don't worry. You can always start today. But what to start? Start karna kya hai? So start filling your box of vocabulary by collecting words. It is very important. If you are not collecting words, your vocabulary box will be empty and you won't be able to use it or convert them into sentences. Start making sentences with those words. Start using those words and sentences for developing two or three lines. Agar aapke paas shabd hai, to unse vakya banaiye. Agar vakya hai, shabd hai, to unko do teen lines mein convert kijiye. Just take those words, make one sentence, make two sentences, three sentences from the same word by changing the meaning of that. Then you can start writing a paragraph on common topics with that. If you are able to make sentences and if you are now able to develop two, three lines, you can always start developing a paragraph on any topic. Start from your home, family, friends, neighbors, country, place where you have been visited. So these are few of the topics on which you can easily write, because आपको इसके लिए कहीं से पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है कि क्या लिखें. You know what is there in your home. You know who are the member of your family. You know who are your friends. How are they? How you behave with them? How they behave with you? So all these things you can understand and write into a paragraph, for which you really don't need any book, because you know these things. You just need to materialize these informations into sentences. Start sharing those paragraphs with your teacher or to guide or even with your friends, so that you can understand where you are making the mistakes, how you can improve them. They will really help you. This is really important. And start paraphrasing. Paraphrasing is one of the very important skills which you must have so that you can develop the comprehending skills with yourself. I will, in later part of this video, I will tell you what paraphrasing is. These are few of the things which you can always start. So all first thing is fill the box of your vocabulary. Just don't let it remain empty. Fill it with lots of words. Those words will play the role of a key to make sentences and then paragraphs and then essays, anything you can develop. Now, how can you enhance your vocabulary? This is also a question. I am telling you all the time that enhance your vocabulary, have good words. But how? How can you have? So subscribing to a word every day is very important. Just choose a word every day. Like today, for me, today is the word happy. So if today I have chosen the word happy, I can make different sentences from the word happy. Like, I am very happy today. I want to make everyone happy, but I can't make everyone happy. My happiness makes everyone happy in my family. I am very happy as I have learned how to write. Learning gave me lot of happiness. So you can see from a single word, I have made different words. So, and these are very small and simple words, isn't it? So you can also start writing sentences like this. What you need to do, just you need to subscribe a word for a day. Just choose a word a day and just make different sentences from those words. Enchanting a lexical set of vocabulary every day is also very important. Now, what is lexical set of vocabulary? So, the words with similar sound, one word having similar sound with other words, that you need to practice. That can also help you a lot. Make a box of similar words and opposite words, like antonym and synonym. I will tell you about them also in the later part. Recycling the words learned every day in day-to-day use. Recycling is very important. Log kehte hain ki kaise yaad rakhein. So you can't sit and take the paper and then just keep mugging it up and remember it. Aisa nahi hota. If you really want to remember, or if you really want those words to stay in your mind, you need to practice them every time. You need to recycle them every time. Try to use them in your day-to-day conversation with people. उसको आप यूज करने की कोशिश करिए. इट क्वाइट पॉसिबल दैट एट द बिगिनिंग यू जस्ट एज यू डोंट हैव द हैबिट टू डू सो यू विल फॉरगेट टू यूज दोज वर्ड्स. बट मेक इट अ हैबिट. ग्रेजुअली यू विल बी एबल टू यूज इट. सो रिसाइकलिंग द वर्ड्स, बार बार उसको यूज करना इज वन ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट मीन्स टू लर्न डिफरेंट वर्ड्स एवरी डे. अंडरस्टैंड द यूज ऑफ द वर्ड्स इन स्पेसिफिक कॉन्टेक्स्ट एंड अकॉर्डिंगली यूज. Don't use the words abruptly. If if that word do not have the use in that particular context, then don't use them. Like, there is different words for single meaning, like dekhna. So for dekhna, there are different words like look, see, watch, observe. These all mean dekhna. But where will you use those words? In what context you will use them? That is important. Can you use look for everything? No, you can't. Can you use watch for everything? No, you can't. You can't look a movie. You have to watch a movie. Isn't it? You can't see your children. You have to look after your children. So there are different uses of the words. And you have to understand where these words are being used. How to use those words. Treasure all the five forms of the verbs. Or means words. Treasure all the five forms of verbs so that you can really use them whenever you need them. Finding adjectives which suits to your personality and also start with the first letter of your name is always very interesting. In this way, you can also understand what qualities do you have or what qualities others have, and you can always mention them as a quality to them as well as to your own self. Like, I am Chanchala, so I can be creative Chanchala, I can be controlling Chanchala. So in the same way, you can also always find out several adjectives for your name which suits your personality also, and accordingly use them into sentences every day. That's a fun. And most importantly, practicing is the key. You have to practice. There are several ways, but unless and until you practice them, you won't be able to enhance anything. Now let's see. What are the few ways to enhance your vocabulary? So you can always categorize the words. Like in this example, you can see there are different categories of clothes, isn't it? Which you can wear in summer or winter or in rainy days. So you can categorize the words according to the season, like clothes, or you can always categorize different kind of things like subjects. Which are the subjects like English, Hindi, Math. So there are different subjects. Now you can categorize the words related to that subject. Like grammar is there in English and Hindi and in any other languages. But it is not there in science. It is not there in social science. So you can categorize what are the different kind of words which suits to that category. And you can make a list of it. And that is also a way to enhance your vocabulary. Now ranking is another way. Because you need to sequence the sentences, you must know how to rank the sentences. Like, if you want to make your younger students learn them, you can always start with easy things like part of body. But if you are a grown-up child and if you want to learn, you can start like hierarchy of post in a company. How they like first one is chairperson, then the lowest rank holders are like peon or clerk, whatever. So in this way, you can enhance your vocabulary about different sets of categories. Okay, matching is another way. How can you match, like one word for many? This is one way of matching, one word for many words. So matching with pictures, matching with antonyms or synonyms. So these are the ways of learning new words. So the word meaning has many, if one word has many meanings, so in order to understand the different meanings and to use them differently, you must have those words. Noticing is another way to enhance your vocabulary. Like you can see in this picture that he is noticing this lady. And in this way, you can narrate them or write them into your diary every day. Like if you have noticed something today, you can always write, I noticed this. Today this had happened. Today specifically this had happened. So in this way, you can always write sentences with noticing few things. Suppose you went to a party and you have noticed few unusual things, you can write it down. So noticing any event of the day is a good function to write it write in the diary. Like today the number of viewers increased on this channel. This is what I have noticed today. So in this way you can always enhance your vocabulary. Another way is word search. So through word search also you can enhance your vocabulary. By seeing this example, you can clearly, there are a lot of puzzle boxes in newspapers, and now there are different games altogether. So you can play them. Word game is there through which you can enhance your vocabulary. So these are few of the ways, and there are lots of other ways. I'm not claiming that only these are the ways. These are few of the examples. So you can always use whatever ways you like to improve your vocabulary. So various ways, and you can choose any one. Now let's see how rewording the sentences by finding synonyms for the word. How can you reword? So what are synonyms? You all know. You can see this emojis. They all are smiling, isn't it? Someone is smiling by showing the whole teeth. Someone is just smiling. Someone is laughing mysterious way. Someone is laughing louder. And someone is like, So these are the different smiles, isn't it? But all what they are doing, they all are smiling or laughing. So there is one word, laughing and smiling. But they need to be categorized in different ways, because you can clearly find the differences in their laughs, isn't it? Synonyms are the words that have the same meaning. Meaning is same, but they are used in different context. So what can you really do? You can create a situation, and then you can find the word for that situation. Like here, the word situation can be laughing, and the word can be laugh or smile. Now list out the synonyms for that word. Find out what are the different kind of words which can be used for that. Make as many sentences as you can with all the synonyms that you can always practice. You should make a note that whatever you are making the sentences with the synonyms, the meaning should remain same. Wo uska matlab nahi badalna chahiye. Words can be changed. Synonyms say words, sentences change honge, but uska matlab wahi rehna chahiye. That is the core thing. Now let's see few of the examples. How does it work? So let's see few of the examples. Let's observe few of the illustrations. Let's notice few of the exercises. Let's watch few of the demonstrations. Let's take a note of few of such cases. So in these sentences, what you can see that the see, observe, notice, watch, take a note is all used to make you pay attention. If I want to make you pay attention to this, I can use all these words. So there is one word, pay attention. And for that, I am using different words. And here again, this example, illustration, exercise, demonstration, or cases, these all are the synonyms of examples. In sare sentences ka matlab ek hi hai. We have just changed or swapped the words with the synonyms, and see how we have made different sentences from the same meaning. Isn't it wonderful? Isn't it easy to make these sentences? Is it difficult? No, it's not difficult. So this is how you can make. You can see these two pictures. This one emoji is of laughing and another one is of sad face. So happy and sad. This emoji is saying I am fine, but actually it is pretending. So he is also happy and sad. Two versions of the same thing. So reversing the sentence by using antonyms is another way to make different sentences. What are antonyms? Antonyms are words that have opposite meaning. Earlier we discussed synonyms and now antonyms. So the key is the same. Create a situation. Find the word for the situation. Find out the antonym for that word. And make as many sentences as you can with all the synonyms. And let's see how does it work. So here, let's not waste our time. Let's cultivate this opportunity. Let's use these examples. Let's enhance our ability of writing. Let's use the time productively for writing sentences. So you can note that the meaning of the sentences should be opposite. The first sentence is, let's not waste our time, is the first sentence. So we have tried to create the opposite of this. So waste is the word here. Waste means barbaad karna. Now we are trying to use the different antonyms of it. So the antonym can be cultivate, useful, enhance, productive. All these are the antonyms of waste. And how we have used these words into the sentences so that the meaning can be just opposite. Time barbaad nahi karne ke liye, we can cultivate the time, we can cultivate the opportunity, we can use these examples, we can use the time productively for writing sentences. So in this way, you can make different sentences with one word. You just find the word, this is waste, and now I have tried to find out the different antonyms of these words, and after finding the antonyms of the words, I have made different sentences. and all these sentences are opposite to the first sentence. So in this way you can really enhance your sentence making ability. So I hope you have understood. Start interrogating and use question tag. So questioning is very important. Asking question is an art. It is very easy to give answers. In classroom, when the teacher asks a question, everybody raise their hand. But if you will tell that you frame a question and ask, nobody will ask. Why? Because they will always have this hesitation. Kahin galat to nahi pooch liya, question irrelevant to nahi hai. How to ask, what to ask, what will be the sentence. And in order to get correct answer, you should ask correct question. So making questions is important. So for practicing, one can do, prepare a list of questions about the household things. If you are really beginning to practice these things, or you can start with study materials which you can see at your home, or work related things which you have at your home. So these are few of the things which you really observe on your daily basis. Now you have to prepare a list of them. For example, cleaning. If you are in house, you have to clean your house. In this pandemic period, cleaning is must. If you are a student, you must have some books, or you must have some laptops. If you are working also, you must have these things. So now we have these words. Now let's see how we can make some questions out of it. So mommy, when will you do cleaning today? You can ask a question to your mother. Or why am I not getting any of my books here? You can always ask this. Mera kitabe kahan hai? Or do you know anyone who can repair this laptop? So these are few of the questions which you can, not these questions, you can make any question out of anything which you are observing at your home. So what are you waiting for? Start now. Why am I not able to write? You can always ask this question to yourself. What is the reason behind it? What should I do to practice? From where should I start? I can write, can't I? I should practice, shouldn't I? I will be a writer one day, won't I? So, here in these sentences, you can see these are interrogation. You have to ask these questions to your own self. And you can also use this means to make another questions so that you can ask to anyone. And these are the question tags which are used here. In this way, you can really make different kind of sentences. It will help you to enhance your writing abilities. There is another way, which is model auxiliary for setting the tone of a sentence. So you can see this beautiful girl. She is wearing some jewelry and all so that she can look beautiful. So why do we wear jewelry? We wear jewelry in the perception that we will look beautiful. So in order to make ourselves beautiful, we use different kind of things to look good. Jewelries are one of them. So, in language, these modal auxiliary verbs are the jewelries and ornaments of language. If you want your sentences to be polite, you should use modal auxiliary verbs so that you can really sound nice. So, you can always use them for like being probability. If there is a probability of something like, I may bring another video on writing skill. It's a probability. I may not. I may. There is a chance of yes and no. Or showing power. I can write whatever I want to write. It is a, like power. Yes, I can. I will. Or if you have some abilities, you can write. Like I can write as well as speak in English. So these writing and speaking are the ability of someone. Requesting, for requesting someone. Will you please share your doubts with me? Advising. You must practice every day. This is my advice. Discussing. Shall we discuss on the topic? Or what shall we discuss next? So these are few of the modal auxiliary verbs. If you want to warn someone, don't you dare to write rubbish things. Or if you want to ask permission or consent or question, so you can always ask like, will you please tell me which video I should make next? May I know your questions about the videos? So in this way, you can make sentences. So you just need to learn those modal auxiliary verb. If you want, I will make separate video on modal auxiliary verb. So you can always make those words into sentences and then use it. So now I want you to read this paragraph for a second. And for now, as you are not here, let me read. I wanted to write my views. Sorry, I couldn't. It was very difficult to crack down how to start writing. I managed to find a way. Every time I start writing, I get confused. I have not yet given up my hopes to be able to write one day. I started writing sentences. I started developing paragraphs. I am now able to write my own article. It was proved that when there is a will, there is a way. So, now let's read another paragraph. I wanted to write my views, but sorry, I couldn't. Although it was very difficult to crack down how to start writing, but still I managed to find a way. Every time I start writing, I get confused. However, I have not given up my hopes to be able to write one day. Taking a step ahead, I started writing sentences and gradually I started developing paragraphs and eventually I am now able to write my own article and ultimately it was proved that when there is a will, there is a way. So can you find out the differences in these two paragraphs? So this paragraph is without any discourse markers and this paragraph is with discourse markers. So can you imagine how this red words had brought differences in the paragraph? You can always use these discourses to enhance your paragraphs, to make the flow. In this paragraph, although the sentences are correct, but there is something missing. And those missing things are these discourses. When we use these discourses in our paragraphs, it enrich our paragraph very much. So that you can also make complex sentences with all these discourses. So discourse, use of discourse makers in sentences for transition is very important. I have told you that how to maintain the transition and flow is important for developing a paragraph or to be a good writer. So these are the discourse markers which you can always use to enhance the effectiveness of the paragraph which you are writing. There are lots of other discourse markers, which few of them are here. Like further, it had been found that, after that, or look, this is what happened. Believe me, I am telling you the truth. And that is how, first of all, in the end, everything was fine. So, these are few of the discourse markers which you can always use in the sentences so that you can make your paragraph very effective and they really help you to move ahead. They really help you to take the further step so that you can achieve that transition. Wo missing nahi lagta hai ki kahan ye chhoot raha hai, kahan gayab ho raha hai, link nahi hai kuch. So these words helps you to create the link between the lines. Jo lines ke beech mein links hote hai na, jo gayab ho jane pe adhura sa feel hota hai. So they help you to make those sentences connected and make that flow. Now there is another way. You can see this picture. आप क्या देख रहे हो इस पिक्चर में? There is a boy and he is looking into the mirror and he is seeing his own reflection. This is like paraphrasing. Paraphrasing में what we do is we take the original thing and we try to replicate it with our own words. Actually it is not our original but we try to replicate it. So this is a very important way to develop writing. What we have to focus is meaning should not be changed. Whatever you are changing, whatever, like in this, when you see into a mirror, your reflection is almost same as you are. Meaning should not be changed of that paragraph. It should be easy to understand. It should not be too long. It can also develop the comprehending skill. Paraphrasing is a very important skill. So I can give you one example here. So you can read this paragraph. Writing is a skill. Outlining is creating a plan for the structure and flow of a piece of writing. Good writing needs to have a logical structure in order to make sense to a reader. Your ability to organize sentences and paragraphs in the most compelling way influences how others perceive you and understand the point of your writing. Now let's see. This is a paragraph taken from Wikipedia on writing skills. And now let's see the paraphrased paragraph which I have done. Writing is an art in which planning and organizing the flow of the topic is important. There should be a logical sequencing and structuring so that the reader can clearly understand whatever has been written. The ability of organizing the paragraphs and maintaining the flow can really impact the reader. The reader can easily perceive your writing style and understand your point of view through your writing. So you can see the meaning has not been changed. These both paragraphs give emphasis on writing skills, how a paragraph can be developed, but the sentences are little bit changed. So this is paraphrasing. That means you can take a paragraph from anywhere, from any book or from any Wikipedia or social site search engines, and you just try to rephrase them with your own words, but meaning should not be changed. So this will really help you to comprehend, really help you to understand. And here you can also see that so many discourses has been used, discourse markers has been used, modal verbs has been used. So in this way, you can really use all those skills to develop a paragraph. I hope you have understood. So what are you waiting for? Start writing. The key to start writing is practice, 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 and practice. So take your pen and start writing. I hope you have understood. If you like the video, then please don't forget to share this with everyone. And please subscribe the channel for more such videos and keep advising for what you want next. Thank you very much and happy writing. Keep writing. Thank you.